Hola a todos y bienvenidos de nuevo to Out by the Popcorn. Si son nuevos, yo me llamo Stephanie. Muchas gracias a todos for clicking on this video. Estamos en los últimos capítulos. Ya no más falta que una semana o dos semanas. Pero ahora vamos a estar hablando de la semana 12. So let's get on with this recap. Pues ya como miramos que Sofía y Teresa have reunited and it feels so good. Pero, como saben mucho, they end up being a threat. So, of course, they're trying to take them out. So, el gobierno ends up executing plan B. And they end up putting una bomba en el avión que Teresa, Sofía y Jonathan are going to use to get out of Mexico. Están en el avión, like, doing all the checks. Sofía se da cuenta que no tiene a Tots y lo dejó en el carro. Which, en ese momento, is kind of like, why did that click in? Que there's something wrong with that. Que cuando Lupo le dijo que se escapara, dijo, yo no me voy sin mi gato. Y every time something happens, siempre que su gato. So, ¿cómo fue? Like, now that you think about it, it's like, why didn't that, like, trigger que, oh, that's, like, part of a plan. Esa viene saliéndose del avión. Se queda ahí Jonathan and Sofía. Y, pues, cuando Teresa is getting the cat, pues, the plane explodes. Esta Manuela, of course, like, tries to come out and, like, take Teresa out by shooting. They end up having, like, this really awkward, like, shootout. Cuando Manuela, like, gets on that forklift. So, we're gonna move past that. Manuela ends up escaping, Teresa ends up escaping, y ya se va y le dice al Scooby King todo lo que pasó. I went forward to, muy rápido me fui para adelante. Obviamente yo dije, no es posible que Sofía esté muerta. There's no possible way, todo esto to get her, for her to die. Like, no. Yo dije, pues si alguien se muere, pues va a ser Jonathan, ¿verdad? I was like, Jonathan a lo mejor somehow se dio cuenta que there was a bomb al último momento, y like, sacó a Sofía somehow way out of the plane. Lupo, like, gave him the heads up que, okay, como this is happening, they're gonna execute this plan. They know that you have a plane. They're gonna put a bomb in there. You're gonna have 2 minutes, pero they're gonna be listening in. So you're gonna have to sell it. Claro, todo lo que está pasando, like, it's bigger. Tú no piensas que es aquí and it just gets bigger plan. Piénselo como un magician's trick, right? Te tienen mirando en esta mano, like, just enfócate en esta parte, pero todo está pasando acá. No está mirando acá uno, te tienen enfocado over here, pero acá está pasando todo, like, the behind the scenes, everything's happening over here. But right before lo dimos cuenta que for sure they were alive, and before we find out the behind the scenes of the what was happening over here, Jonathan viene, está hablando con Teresa, y no lo hacen como en this big way that he's alive, this big dramatic, like, reveal, ¿verdad? It's like, oh, soy yo, kind of deal, and, like, están hablando. Luego, yo al principio, yo pensaba que era como, like, a daydream, like, hallucinating, y dije, oh, está soñando algo, like, ese whole scene, I honestly, I wasn't thinking que it was real. Especialmente en el punto when they hooked up together, I'm just like, wait. That's all I'm gonna say about that. Más que se me hizo chistoso que cómo fue que he put that little door back on there. I mean, I guess lo hizo porque, like, when they did the investigation, they would know que this was, like, unhinged before it exploded. I'm assuming so. They're trying to kind of cover up their tracks. I don't know. Pero se escapan y Jonathan va y la lleva con la Galletana. So Galletana kind of basically like won, but like not really porque Teresa ultimately lo hizo to bring the daughter to safety. Vamos a dejar a ellos y vamos acá con Alejandro. Alejandro manda a Danilo para Washington para su seguridad. Entonces damos cuenta que all the chess pieces, this is where it was all leading up to this bigger game of Jaime Alejandro officially beat president. Porque yo había dicho que como que era Alejandro was basically gonna be president, but iba a estar basically manipulating Alejandro from what orders he got. Pero no. They were, of course, thinking bigger. And you know what? We're just gonna take this little puppet. We're done with him. We're gonna dispose of him. And we're gonna bring in this other guy over here. Alejandro, pues, no sabe cómo sentirse muy bien de esto. Porque, regardless, es su brother-in-law. Y quiere a su hermana, like, y está embarazada. Y how is he gonna do this? Pero orders are orders, but he can't really wrap his mind around it. Claro que Eric from the DEA, le dice, you know what? This is done all the time. This isn't anything new. You know this. these are the plans, this is what's gonna happen. Hello, future president of Mexico. Vamos a ir acá con el zurdo. El zurdo, pues, you know, he's in the hospital porque, you know, he fell out of the damn helicopter. Pero como que está dando órdenes, Lencho ends up sneaking into the room, kind of gave me night and day kind of vibes. Obviamente, he wants his revenge on Teresa. Si se dieron cuenta, where was the hideout location? Thankfully, they're always, like, on top of things. Y en la casa donde estaban, pues, they had, like, a panic room. Honestly, that whole scene was kind of lame. It was kind of really bad acting. I really thought so. I guess porque como saben su situation, they knew something like this was gonna happen. I get it. They have their plan executed. Pero, like, regardless, I mean, you're sitting, you're having dinner, and you know that there's killers out there. I feel que they should have been, like, more panic arrived. Pero, you know, they're like, no, está bien, Teresa los dijo qué hacer, vámonos. And then, like, they just went and they ended up having, like, a panic room there. Pero cuando llegaron la gente del zurdo, y estaban checando la comida, that gave me, Pineapple Express vibes when that, was his face, like, put his hands in there, it's like, oh, it's so warm. But in this case, Lencho, like, tasted the food and was like, todavía está calientita. No estaba todo el Scooby Gang allí tampoco en la casa. El rey les habló porque, you know, through the little fancy watch, he gave him a heads up that they were outside. Rey, in the meantime, estaba having dinner acá con Jimena y su familia and was getting to know them. En ese momento se da cuenta que Epifanio is related to Jimena. Of course, se pues, enoja, ¿verdad? Porque cómo es que nunca te me dijiste que el candidato era, you know, tu abuelo. Dice, no, pues yo nomás lo he mirado como si acaso 20 veces en mi vida y eso es mucho. You know, he's like, whatever to me. Eso es lo que dijo esta, oh, shit, what's her name, Mercedes, ¿es that it? La abuela de Jimena. Cuando dice, ay, somos gente educada y decente. Quedé como, like, really? Really? Tú vas a decir esto, like, somos decente y gente educada. This coming from la señora que estaba armada a ser la próxima primera dama. To make your ex-husband's life a living hell. Haciendo un punto de ir a buscar what dress shop she was shopping at for her wedding and, like, be childish. Literally, this coming from the woman that was dressed up to go to this wedding to go and ruin it. Pero you're decente and educada. Okay. Keep telling yourself that. Y luego también ya el lunes nos dimos cuenta que Oleg, in fact, sí está vivo. And personally, I would have preferred for them to have drawn that out a little bit more. I would have preferred for them to have waited off. I mean, yo sé que nomás les falta que una o dos semanas para que se acabe la novela. And ahorita, like, esta semana, they didn't even, I mean, he's just there. Lo dimos cuenta el Friday que, in fact, ya estaba despierto, se fue el Batman. Dicen, oye, tienes que levantar, and he opened up his eyes. So you see that he's conscious. Say that they maybe should have played that off, but que esté more dramatic and gave him a more, like, oh, entrance. To me, I think would have been, like, such a better entrance for Oleg in a more dramatic way. Batman está allí diciendo, no, pues fíjate la sorpresa que te tengo, you know, like a little smirk. Y luego here comes, like, Oleg. Nada más como lo están haciendo, pero yo siento como his character deserves better than what he's getting right now. Hoy estamos allí con Oleg y Batman. También miramos cómo fue que Batman vino agarrando a Oleg. Y ese todo flashback scene that they did, I thought was so funny. So, vamos a ir acá con Lupo. El DEA se da cuenta que Lupo estaba ayudando a Teresa. Lupo was basically gonna give Teresa a Manuela, but they kind of interfered. También it's like, Manuela's like literally walking away from you, and you're not talking that quietly cuando le hablas y le marcas a Teresa. Y luego también, like, that whole, like, setup que le pusiste, that you were trying to put up for Manuela, talking about, vamos a cenar y this, this, and that. Like, you were very persistent, Manuela. I was like, no, I'm tired. And, like, I guess Alejandro, like, really, también Alejandro was there, like, he was kind of a distance. Y Alejandro kind of gives her, like, this nod, like, yeah, accept it. And she's all like, okay, está bien. That way we can remember this about, like, old times. Cuando estaba allí Teresa, cuando se estaban llevando a Lupo, she now basically at that moment forgives them. Porque, honestly, you know, she loves them. So now, it's like, are you gonna stay with him? I mean, le dice que, no, I can't get past you kidnapping my child. But at the end, it's like, the heart wants what it wants. I don't know, I might lose respect for you, Teresa, if you take him back. I'm sorry. I know muchos a lo mejor están, pero, like, they belong together. And I'm just like, No, he kidnapped the daughter. I don't care how close they got. And they, no, and the heart. You know what? Screw the heart. He kidnapped your kid. Either way it goes, Jonathan and Teresa got on un plan para to try to find donde están llevando a Lupo. And it involves Manuela's nephew. Basically hold them hostage. En la casa llega Manuela. And it's kind of funny because like now Manuela's like, él no tiene nada que ver con esto. Es un niño. And it's just like, girl. Y Teresa le dice, ¿y mi hija? They put the nephew in otro cuarto. And then Teresa's like, you know, pointing a gun to the door. Diciéndole a Manuela, tell me where they're transferring Lupo. Of course, it's like, no, no, no. She ends up like shooting. Obviamente Manuela's like, no, 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 no. Les dice el plan de dónde lo van a llevar. Jonathan is like, no, eso es una mentira. Ahí nunca llevan a una gente allí. Y Teresa's all like, oh, me estás mintiendo. And she's like, no, que no es que, this is exactly where they're taking him. No le creen, and like shoots at the door donde según lo mata. En ese momento, Manuela's like devastated, like, oh my God, no puedo creer. You literally have killed my whole family. Again, como dijo Teresa, y le estaba diciendo al nephew, yo no maté a tu mamá. I wasn't even there when your mom died. Pues ya Manuela piensa que está muerto el nephew, and kind of goes into a rage and is able to like get free of where she was, you know, being held in the chair. Teresa y el rey take off running. Y Jonathan abre la puerta y pues el nephew obviamente está vivo because, you know, Teresa's not about that life. Nomás que lo pusieron on the floor to be on the safe side. They're all like chasing the, Manuela down the street. Mind you, están en Estados Unidos. I think I forgot to mention that. So it's like, this isn't Mexico. Y'all like shooting and stuff. Like, this is a whole, and then of all places, you're in D.C. Like, really? Manuela shoots Rey in the arm. Turns around Teresa, man, just to like circle around but get ahead of her. And shoots her. Ba 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 ba. Okay? So obviamente, Manuela's dying. Pero... So Manuela está muriéndose y se me hace chistoso porque Teresa is like now crying and feels bad. Talk about, todavía hay tiempo, girlfriend, you shot her like 5 times in the chest. Why are you crying? What did you think was going to happen? Like, were you maybe secretly hoping that she had a bulletproof vest underneath everything? I mean, I don't know, because you crying after shooting this girl like so many times. Like, what the hell did you expect? Maybe if you had shot like in the arm and the leg, but you literally went on into her chest. And obviously, she didn't have a bulletproof vest because you saw all the blood. But I guess maybe when she was shooting, she was hoping. I mean, I don't know. Lee said, well, thank you for reuniting me with my family. Yo dije, a mejor ese punto le va a decir your nephew's still alive. But they didn't. So she ended up dying thinking that she's going to be reunited with all the family. But now, like, your nephew's still alive. So now it's kind of like, is the nephew going to want to try some kind of revenge? I mean, he's not that smart. But, like, rage changes people. But at some point, they escape. No creo que they ever really showed them escaping out of the country. But either way it goes, está para atrás en México. So is Alejandro is back in México. Y va y busca a Epifanio para dirigirle this bigger plan that's been going around. Que basically, they've been puppets in the U.S.'s plot to pick, to handpick the next president of Mexico. So Epifanio is like, ¿Qué estás hablando, mijita? No te entiendo. Y te dijo, no, escúcheme. They're gonna try to, like, kill you. Pero no creo que le alcanzó a decir todo porque es cuando Alejandro vino. Pero sí le vino diciendo que they're basically trying to assassinate him. I don't remember si le alcanzó a decir que Alejandro was DEA and that he's supposed to be the next president. I don't recall. Pero a lo mejor sí, porque ya cuando se estaban yendo, Epifanio le estaba diciendo to clear out the rest of the schedule, but he wanted like some personal time, and he was kind of like looking at Alejandro kind of like, you're trying to kill me. So maybe he did, I just don't remember. I really don't remember. Let me know in the comment section below si le alcanzó a decir que Alejandro was DEA and he was supposed to be the next president. But really quickly acá con the other candidate, obviamente el zurdo ended up making a deal con el government, acknowledging and admitting que he was financing the other candidate's campaign. Obviamente, he's out of the race now and made it a shoe-in for Epifanio to be the next president because there's no other candidate to go against him. But al último, you know, obviamente, you can't trust the government here, there, anywhere. He ended up getting his escape plan Which, of course, obviamente, Lencho helped them out. Fue con, like, this big old, like, laundry basket. He went in there, and then they, like, took off. It was so funny, porque cuando lo subieron a la troca, y ahí estaba, se quedó una guita ahí, like, le dice, Lencho, ¿estás bien? Pues, ¿qué quieren? ¿Un selfie? Like, let's go, because they were, like, out there lingering for a minute. It's like, dude, like, you're, like, escaping. Like, literally, you're, like, trying to, like, flee a fugitive, and you're just, like, there. It should have been, like, up, close the doors, let's go. And it's kind of like, up, are you okay? Linger, linger, linger. And then close the doors and go. A mí se me hace que ya fue todo por la semana. I mean, you know, ya cuando estamos llegando a los finales, it gets like really, really good. Espero que disfrutaron de este video. No se les olvide darle un like. Suscríbase a mi canal si todavía no lo han hecho. No se les olvide tocar la campanita para que estén notificados cada vez que pongo un video nuevo. Y hasta la próxima semana. Adiós.